Vast waterways and their design, how we design it, and water harvesting system and its different techniques. So first of all, what we have to learn in this lecture, the first is definition of grassed waterways, its purpose, its design, its selection, how to select the suitable grass, because the word describe it, grassed waterways. So it means we have to grow some kind of grasses there. Then its construction, and then water harvesting definition and types of water harvestings and water harvesting techniques. So we have to study all these points one by one. So first we have to study what is grassed waterways. So grassed waterways are natural or man-made constructed channels established for the transport of concentrated flow at safe velocities for the catchment using adequate erosion resistant vegetation which cover the channels. It means that are like we have constructed water channels in our field. Similarly, we are constructed grass waterways to control the soil erosion. Okay, we are constructing grassed waterways. I hope this definition is clear to you all. So that we have to control the erosion taken place in large amount. As you know, two types of erosion eroded the soil at very large quantity, in very large quantity, that is rill and gully erosion. So that's why we have to construct grass waterways so that the erosion quantity and its the flow, the runoff should be minimum. Okay. Next point is the grass waterways are open channel protected with suitable grasses or shrubs. It is a simply drainage channel. Similar as water channel, it is grass waterways, means these are also the open channels. Okay, like in our fields, there are open water channels. Similarly, in grass waterways, these are also open channels which are protected our soil to get eroded, and we have to grow some kind of suitable grasses there, some kind of shrubs. The waterways are these are the outlets prior to the like we are constructed bunds. Why we are constructed bunds? So that our these kind of waterways, because to control the soil erosion and like burns, we have to construct it also. Okay, where there is a large amount of erosion takes place, we have to construct grass waterways. Okay, so it is a diagram. Many of you see them in your fields, or many of you see in the pictures also, and then both the pictures are the examples of grass waterways. Okay. So here we see that there is on the both sides there is crop, and in between the crops there is a longitudinal waterway so that the water get easily moved via grass. Okay, so the soil can't move through it. Okay, so next is the purpose of grass waterways. What is the purpose? The first purpose is the grassed waterways are used to outlets to prevent rill and gully formation. Means in previous lecture, I already tell you about the rill and gully erosions. Okay, so to prevent these type of erosions, to prevent the formation of rill and gullies, we have to use grass waterways so that our water cannot take our soil from the original surface. Okay, so we are constructing it. Or when it is properly constructed, the grass waterways can safely transport large amount of water into the downslope. And these waterways can also be used as outlets for the water to move out from one place to another place, okay, or into the river or into a pond. The next point is, this is the best management practice we are following up, so it can reduce the sedimentation, means the movement of soil particles, I can say. And the vegetation also improves the soil aeration, the water holding capacity of the soil, because when we are growing some kind of crop there, some kind of grasses there, so they can hold the soil, and they also increase its fertility, it also improves its water holding capacity. So it is considered as a best management practice without the use of any kind of herbicides, pesticides and phosphorus, any kind of insecticides. And then next is the design of grass waterways. So the designs of grass water wheel is similar to the irrigation channel we are, or we can say water channel. Okay, as we are constructing the water channel or irrigation channel, grass water wheels are also similar. But one thing is important in it, that is we have to grow there some kind of grasses. Okay, and we are about, if we construct a grass water wheels, so it can use it. We can use it for maximum 10 years. Okay, the 10 years run of the means the quality of the intensity of rainfall. Okay, so 10 year recurrence interval period होता है, means इसका मतलब क्या है कि जितनी ज़्यादा बारिश होती रहे उस grass water wheel को कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, वो 10 साल तक वैसे की वैसे ही रहती है. Okay, so first is what we have to note, there are 5 points we have to include to design a grass waterway. First is the size of the waterway, so it is depend upon the expected runoff, means in how much amount the runoff is taking place. Is it taking place in a high amount or low amount or medium amount? It depend on that. If there is a high rainfall area, so we have to construct a larger waterway, or we can say chodi honi chahiye, theek hai, wo kafi zyada. So we have to use it as a cross sectional area, and there is a formula, that is A is equal to Q by V. So A is the cross sectional area of the channel, and Q is the expected maximum runoff of that area, and V is the velocity of the flow, means how much velocity, in meter per second. Okay, the velocity is the speed. How much speed is taking place for the runoff? Is it going slow or it is going very fast? So it depends upon the area, the slope, everything. So next is the shape of the waterway. What kind of shape we have to consider for developing or making a grassed waterway? The shape of the waterway depend upon the field condition. Okay, as like the size, similar conditions will be followed up. Especially the field condition, the type of construction equipment, what kind of equipment you are using to construct that waterway. And there are three common shapes, trapezoidal, triangular and parabolic shapes. Okay, I will show you next slide. So these are divided into three because of their slopes. Okay, so here you see that the slope, where is the slope is less, there is a parabolic, well, curvy nature. Okay, the parabolic is curvy. And trapezoidal means it has, like, we have to make a trench like structure. Okay, it is very deep as compared to parabolic. Trapezoidal is deep. Similarly, we have to make a triangular. Okay, where the slope is so much steep. जहाँ पे तीखे slope है वहाँ पे हम triangular follow up लेंगे. Triangular grass waterway का follow up लेंगे. Then the channel flow velocity. Okay, means how much is the velocity of the channel? How the flow is going? Okay, the velocity of a flow in a grass waterway is dependent on the condition of the vegetation, means which type of vegetation you are growing. As you know, when the rainfall start, heavy rainfall take place, so our in a flood condition our crops also get eroded from our or removed from the soil surface with water. So the velocity of the rainfall, the flow depend upon the on which type of grass water we have to use. Okay, so there is a table. See, like, recommended velocity of a flow in a vegetative channel means if there is a spare green cover. Spare green cover means on some small areas, not in patches, I can say. Okay, then the velocity is low. Okay, then the magnitude is 1 to 1.5. okay, then good quality. If there is a good quality cover, means the whole area is covered into proper vegetation, there is a proper growth of crops, and then there is a medium velocity of that water. Okay, the velocity of the flow will be medium. The magnitude is 1.5 to 1.8. And if there is excellent quality cover, means it contains all type of, I can say, all type of vegetations, the deep rooted, short rooted, medium rooted, all type of crops are there, then there is a high velocity. Why there is a high velocity? Because pani kya karta hai, bahut tezi se wahan se beh ke jayega fir. ठीक है, क्योंकि जितनी ज़्यादा जगह वो कैरी करेगा तो उतनी ज़्यादा हाई वेलोसिटी होगी, वहाँ से उतनी ज़्यादा पानी जो है वो फास्टली मूव करेगा. ठीक है, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द स्पीड. देन फोर्थ पॉइंट इज द डिज़ाइन ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन. दैट जो भी हमने पीछे पैराबॉलिक, ट्रेपिजॉइडल एंड तीसरा था हमारा ट्राइंगुलर, उसके बारे में पढ़ा, तो वो उसको सेक्शनल एरिया. सो हाउ वी कैन डिज़ाइन इट. ठीक है, सो वी हैव टू यूज अ फॉर्मूला, दैट इज मैनिंग फॉर्मूला. For checking out the cross section, to make a cross section, we have to use a equation, that is V is equal to S half R 2 by 3 by N, where is V is the velocity of flow in meter per second. Okay, we have to, how we can check the velocity of the flow? So we can check by this formula. Then S is the energy slope in mm per mm, means slope length, I can say. Okay, R is the hydraulic, means radius of the section in meter, and means I can say, suppose I have an area like this, okay? So there is my grassed waterway and it is in triangular form. Like I have made my grassway in a triangular form and there is our field, okay? So how much velocity the water coming here and get flowed out through it, and then it is the slope, okay? How is the slope and the ratio? We have to take the medium radius. What is radius? It is the point to the circumference, okay? Center point to the circumference, that is radius. So we have to take the hydraulic mean radius of the section in meters. We have to check out in meters this area, okay? This area. Then N is the manning roughness coefficient. Okay, it depended upon our vegetation, what type of vegetation we are growing, or it is fully vegetated or in patches. So wait a second. So this all come under design of a cross section. So next is the construction of water, how we have to construct it. Okay. It is the advantageous to construct the waterways at least one season before the bunding. Means we have to construct waterways before one season. Means if you are growing some kind of crop in, I can say July or August, so you have to build a waterway in before that sowing of that crop. Okay, it means one season before. Then it will give time for the grasses, because we have to grow there grasses. So grass need very much time to grow in a proper condition, so it take time for proper growth. Okay, so we have to construct it before one season. Okay, then the area is then plowed if necessary and smoothen. If there is a need of plowing there, you have to do plowing there and smoothen that area. And then you have to do your seeding and sowing technique. Seeding and sowing means if you are doing, I can say we have to use seedlings of the grass, or we can say the roots of the grass. So that is sowing technique, or we directly do with seeding, okay, seeding process. Then maintenance of the waterways is important. If you're seeing there is a rupture or there is a some kind of problem in that waterway, you have to maintain it. Like in case of rice, what you can do, that whole field you have to fill with water and then you do puddling, okay, with tractor. Then but if the one bund get distracted out from there, the whole water get come out. Like in the sense, अगर आपके पास एक रेक्टेंगुलर फील्ड है, यहाँ पे आपने राइस लगा रखी है एंड यहाँ पे बहुत सारा पानी है, ठीक है, राइस को ग्रो करवाने के लिए हमने यहाँ पे पानी लगाया हुआ है एंड आप ट्रैक्टर से यहाँ पे पडलिंग कर रही है, और ये होती है हमारी बंड्स, ठीक है। अगर एक भी बंड यहाँ से, मतलब कि हम बोल सकते हैं नैरो हुई, या अगर हमने प्रॉपर मिट्टी नहीं लगाई हुई, तो सारा पानी निकल जाएगा, राइट? तो सिमिलरली ग्रास वाटर वेज भी ऐसे होती हैं, अगर उन वहाँ से अगर कोई पॉइंट निकल गया तो वो सारा पानी कहाँ चले जाएगा, हमारे फील्ड के अंदर, और हमारी सारी क्रॉप्स को डिस्ट्रॉय कर देगा। हो आई होप दिस पॉइंट इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल। देन removal of weeds and filling of the patches with grasses and proper cutting of the grass. What we have to do, you know, grass can be grown very, if once it started growing, it grow very fast, you know, especially in the rainy season. So there is a need of proper cutting, and if there is a patches in that grass way, you have to fill it with grass, okay? You have to pour it with grass. Then also you have to remove weeds from there, because weeds are undesirable plant which grown in our fields, okay? So we have to remove it, because once it is get scattering through wind, so it the whole field become very, I can say, weedful. Okay, so there is a proper, we have to use proper maintenance operations there. Then selection of suitable grasses. So the soil and climate condition are the primary factor for choosing any kind of grass. Okay, and also the construction of grass to waterways. And the other factor, it is considering the suitable selection of a suitable grasses on the basis of the duration of its establishment, means the duration of the growth of that grass, then the volume, the velocity of runoff, means how much it control the velocity of runoff. Okay, then ease of establishment, then time required to develop a good vegetative cover. And generally हम जो grass लगाते हैं on waterways में, that is rhizomatous grasses that are preferred for the waterway because they can spread very quickly, बहुत जल्दी फैलते हैं and provide more protection to the channel than the brush grasses. Okay, बहुत अच्छे से वो protect करते हैं हमारे पूरे channel को, पूरे waterway को. And we have to use deep rooted legumes which are used for grass waterway also. डीप रूटेड इसलिए क्योंकि वो इजीली पानी से रिमूव नहीं होती. ठीक है, दे हैव द टेंडेंसी, एक तो टेंडेंसी होती है उनके अंदर मिट्टी को सॉफ्ट रखने की. ओके, एंड समटाइम वी हैव टू यूज अ लाइट सीडिंग ऑफ स्मॉल ग्रेन. हम क्या करते हैं, स्मॉल ग्रेन क्रॉप्स भी लगा सकते हैं. ठीक है, I will show you a diagram. This is the rhizomatous grass you have seen in your areas too much, near the river also and many other areas. Okay, foreign mein bahut achhi hoti hai. Then the construction and maintenance of grass waterways. So the construction of grass waterways have carried out into four steps. Okay, it include four steps. First is digging or shaping, means if the soil is not proper plowed or we can say not proper cultivated, so we have to cultivate it, we have dig it properly so that the grass waterway can get a get in a proper shape. Then setting is grass planting. So you know we are using grass waterway, so we have to use grasses there. Then ballasting is followed up in those area where there is a rock. Okay, we have to make the waterway with rocks. Okay, small type of rocks hum bol sakte hain, kankar patthar, stubbles bolte hain unko. Theek hai, and the fourth process is placing of structure. We have to place it in a proper structure, ye na ho ki ubar khabad usko banaya jaye. We have to use proper structure for maintaining this grass waterway. Some are there are some points regarding the maintenance, that grasses grown in waterway should always be kept short and flexible. Okay, ye na badi badi ghas laga do, theek hai, ek proper ghas lagani hai and usko hame kya hai bar bar cutting karni hai. Mowing kya hoti hai, we have to cut it out the grass for 2 to 3 times and we have to take it off. Jo bhi grass kati hui hogi usko bahar nikalna hai, wahi pe nahi chhod ke aana hai. Theek hai, नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज न्यूली एस्टेब्लिश वाटरवे शुड बी केप्ट अंडर स्ट्रिक्ट वॉच. ये ना हो कि जहाँ पे आपने न्यू ग्रास वेव बनाई, वाटर वे बनाई है, वो न्यूली बनी है और बारिश हुई, वो टूट फूट गई, तो उसके लिए हमें स्ट्रिक्टली वहाँ पे सुपरविजन करनी होती. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज इफ देर इज एनी ब्रेक इन द चैनल और स्ट्रक्चर देन दे शुड बी रिपेयर्ड इमिडिएटली. उसी टाइम आपको रिपेयर करना है उसको. एंड इट इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल टू कीप द ग्रासेज शॉर्ट by light pasturing, means we have to grow the short type of grasses which is short in height. Okay, and the we have to use proper type of manure, we have to apply manuring also there, and we have to avoid the grazing. Too much grazing result in loss of soil in high amount, so grazing wahan pe nahi karwani hai. Theek hai, and the waterway should not use as a road. Theek hai, वहाँ पे ये ना हो कि आपकी कैटल्स जो हैं उस एरिया में निकल रही हैं, सो इट बिकम अ रोड फॉर देम. ओके, द वाटरवे शुड नॉट बी यूज्ड एज अ रोड फॉर लाइफ स्टॉक. एंड आफ्टर द वेजिटेटिव कवर एस्टेब्लिश द रन ऑफ पासिस थ्रू them for a long time. And a light application of fertilizer should be done because flowing runoff remove the plant's food from the soil or waterway. Means what they are saying that we have to apply some kind of fertilizer there. Not in high amount, in a light application. So that our plant food cannot be get disturbed or cannot be get destroyed. So we have to apply fertilizer, I can say one after in two or three doses in a light application, because jab wahan se pani niklega to soil bhi thodi si niklegi, is wajah se hame wahan pe fertilizer bhi apply karne padte taki soil jo hamare plant hai unko koi kami na ho. Then we talk about the water harvesting system. So water harvesting system, it is a technology for collecting and storing rainwater for human use, or we can say for irrigation purpose or for some other agriculture operations. So hum kya karte hain rainwater mein, पानी को कलेक्ट करते हैं एक पर्टिकुलर, हम बोल सकते हैं जार में या पोर्ट में, या फिर इंजीनियर टेक्निक्स डिफरेंट डिफरेंट फॉलो अप ली गई हैं, उसमें हम क्या करते हैं रेन वाटर को स्टोर करके रखते हैं. नेक्स्ट इज, इट इज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट वाटर सोर्स इन मैनी एरियाज. वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग सिस्टम इज फॉलोड अप इन दोज एरिया वेयर देयर इज़ अ लैक ऑफ आई कैन से वाटर, और देयर इज़ नॉट अ प्रॉपर सप्लाई ऑफ वाटर एंड देयर इज़ लैक ऑफ रेनफॉल देयर. सो इट इज़ अ गुड ऑप्शन in those area where there is a, I can say fresh water is there, is the good in, is in a good quality, and groundwater is lacking. So we have to use a rainwater harvesting system there. So importance of water harvesting system, first is the improvement in the quality of groundwater, as we are consuming all the rooftop water and put it in a proper place so that we can reuse it, or in a pot, okay, the pot or with or the jars we are taking, these are not small type of pots, we are constructing in a large amount, okay, as you are seeing in your AGC farm, okay, there is a pond which collect all the roof water coming from the rainfall. It is not small in structure. So it also improve the water ground water, because all the water get into the soil. So it also improve the quality of ground water. Next, rise up the water levels in wells. It also rise the water levels in the wells, or we can say the tube wells. Okay, jaise ab hum baat karte hain ki कई जो हम अगर हमने ट्यूबवेल कर बनाना है तो वहाँ पे हम क्या करते हैं, कभी पानी 300 फुट पे है, 500 फुट पे है, कहीं पे 100 फुट पे है, तो वो क्यों है, क्योंकि वहाँ पे वाटर लेवल डिफर करता है. ओके, इफ देयर इज़ अ रिवर देयर, सो वहाँ पे पानी इजीली अवेलेबल हो जाता है, एंड इफ देयर इट इज़ इन अ वेरी आई कैन से इन अ डेजर्ट एरिया, और वी कैन से इन अ प्लेन एरिया वेयर देयर इज़ अ नो फ्लो ऑफ अ रिवर और देर इज़ नो लेक नो पॉन्ड, सो वहाँ पर जो वाटर लेवल है वो बहुत ज़्यादा कम होते हैं. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट इज द मिटिगेशन ऑफ द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द ड्रॉट एंड अटेनमेंट ऑफ ड्रॉट प्रूफिंग. इट ऑल्सो इम्प्रूव द ड्रॉट कंडीशन. सी, ड्रॉट कंडीशन ऑलवेज कम वैन देर इज़ अ लैक ऑफ वाटर देर. सो इफ यू हैव कंजर्व दैट रेन वाटर, सो इट कैन बी यूज इन फील्ड एंड दैट इम्प्रूव द ड्रॉट. ओके, next is, it is an ideal solution in areas having inadequate water resources. Means, as I earlier say that the areas which have low rainfall or minimum rainfall, so we can use this water harvesting technology in these areas. Okay, it also reduces the soil erosion, because if there is a heavy rainfall in you can say in a month one, okay, so we can conserve that rain, okay, rain water, and then we have to put it in a proper place, so the soil erosion cannot takes place there, because we are conserving the whole water in a proper I can say catchment area, in a proper pond, in a proper pot, or we can say in a proper jar tank or water tank I can say. So it is also decreasing the choking of storm water drains and flooding of roads. And last point is, save of energy to lift groundwater. So we saving our energy We don't need any kind of labor to dig out the tube well, the bore well, and then we are taking the water, we are doing, we are placing motors there. So if we are conserving raw water, we can use it for ourselves also. So types of water harvesting. So basically there are three types of water harvesting. One is rainwater harvesting, second is flood water harvesting, and third is groundwater harvesting. So rainwater harvesting is defined as the method for inducing and collecting, storing and conserving local surface runoff for agriculture. Means we have to conserve the rainwater. ओके जो भी बारिश हो रही है उसको हमने क्या करना है, कलेक्ट करना है, स्टोर करना है, कंजर्व करना है, और हमने फर्दर उसको अपने एग्रीकल्चर में यूज़ करना है. इन एरिड एंड सेमी एरिड रीजन्स, एरिड एंड सेमी एरिड रीजन्स आर दोज रीजन्स विच आर आई कैन से विच हैव हाई टेम्परेचर, दैट आर एरिड एंड सेमी एरिड रीजन्स. ओके देन आवर फ्लड वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग. सो इट इज डिफाइंड एज द कलेक्शन स्टोरेज ऑफ क्रीक फ्लो फॉर इरीगेशन यूज, प्लस हार्वेस्टिंग ऑल्सो नोन एज लार्ज कैटमेंट वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग. मीन्स इफ फ्लड कम्स, सो वट यू कैन डू, यू कैन मेक अ कैचमेंट एरिया. कैचमेंट एरिया क्या होता है, एक बड़ा सा हमने खड्डा खोद रखा, ठीक है, और जितना भी फ्लड आता है, जितना भी अगर फ्लड वाटर आ रहा है वहाँ पर वो कंजर्व हो जाता है. That is flood water harvesting. Okay, then groundwater harvesting. So this is a new technique implemented in agriculture, but it is not followed up in that much condition. So we have to use some kind of canal systems or underground dams we are making for conserving the groundwater. Okay, so these are some example of it. Now the water harvesting technique. So different for different water harvesting system, there is different water harvesting techniques. First is runoff harvesting. So the runoff harvesting we are using for short term and long term. Okay. The short term runoff harvesting techniques includes the formation of contour burns. We are making contour burns, semicircular hoop, trapezoidal burns, graded burns, rock catchment, ground catchment. So the slides, the next slide will show you some diagram. Okay. Then long term. In long term, we are using some kind of ponds. Okay, the embankment, the reservoir, or we can say the irrigation dam, the farm pond. Okay. So these are the short-term runoff harvesting techniques. That is, we are making contour bund. In first diagram, you are seeing a contour bund. कि हमने एक contour bund बना दी, जिससे हम क्या कर रहे हैं? पानी collect हो जाता है. ठीक है, यहाँ पे आप देख रहे होंगे कि हर plant के पास एक छोटा सा catchment area बना रखा है, और यहाँ पे क्या करते हैं? जब पानी इस soil पे गिरेगा, तो directly it will get in this small catchment area. Okay, near the plant. Next is trapezoidal. So trapezoidal, we have to consider some kind of slope there. Then we have to consider if there is a steep slope, we have to do a trapezoidal one. Okay, ये triangular form में आप देख रहे होंगे. Then is semicircular hoop. So semicircular hoop भी हम जो है वहाँ करते हैं जहाँ पे slope थोड़ी सी कम होती है as compared to trapezoidal. We have to construct this type of bunds there or hoop. Then next is flood water harvesting. So flood water harvesting, we are I can say, guys wait a second. So next is the flood water harvesting techniques we are using. Guys wait a second. So to harvest flood water, wide valleys means वाइड वैलीज, जो भी चौड़ी बनी होती है ना वैलीज, जैसे आप रिवर वैली देखते हो वैसे, उनको ही हम रीशेपिंग कर देते हैं. वी आर डूइंग रीशेपिंग, वी आर प्लेसिंग रॉक्स देयर, वी आर प्लेसिंग सम बिग स्टोन्स देयर, वी आर यूजिंग सम काइंड ऑफ आई कैन से हम रेत की बोरी, सैंड सैक्स भी हम यूज़ करते हैं. सो इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज वाटर स्प्रेडिंग, और वी कैन स्प्रेड इरीगेशन इज, और इसमें होता क्या है, टर्बुलेंट चैनल फ्लो होता है. Is harvested either by diversion or spreading within the channel. What we are doing, we are making multiple channels there. or we can say a valley floor, so that our water get diverted or it can be separated through a valley floor or a channel bed. Then runoff is stored in soil profile. Whole runoff get get moved into that I can say in that soil. Okay, it has usually long catchment, means that is in kilometers, that is not in meters, that is in kilometer, that is very large, and the ratio is between the catchment and the cultivated area lies between 10:1. Means if the catchment area is 10 kilometer, then the cultivated is cultivated area is 1 acre. It is considered, we have to consider it like that. That is not in a small quantity, because when flood comes, it comes in a very large amount. It can't come in a few meters. It can't go up to a minute. It come through. I can say in very large amount. Okay, it covers whole area, whole district, whole village. So the catchment area. So as the catchment area should be in kilometers. Then it has a provision for overflow of excess water. So there should be a outlet in which the excess water also move to another catchment area. So we are using their permeable rock dams or water spread bunds. I can show you. So in first diagram you are seeing that permeable rock dam. So what they are using? They are making, there is, this is a river valley, or can say valley. So here we are growing our crops and we are putting some kind of stones here. We are making a rock dam and we are also placing that stones with that I can say the bigger stones in the valley, so that water can move slowly from there, and when it is over flow, then it gone to the our cultivated area. I hope you are getting my point, what I am saying. And in the next picture you are seeing that there is a hilly area and we are constructing some kind of water spreading ones. Means if the water is coming with a heavy flow, so we are constructing the water bunds in alternate manner, on parallel manner. Okay, so that water gets spreaded in different direction and it cannot have any kind of I can say it cannot have harm our crop or harm our soil. Then is ground harvesting. So for ground harvesting technique, we are using canet system. So canet consists of long tunnel or a leading from a well dug at a reliable source of groundwater. Means we are putting a long tunnel, jaise hum sewage dalte hain, waise hi canet system hota hai. We are making a long tunnel and that usko hum bol dete hain mother well. ओके जो कि किसी भी हिल के नीचे डाला जाता है, बेस ऑफ द हिल डाला जाता है या फुट हिल्स पे डाला जाता है. ठीक है, और वी हैव फॉलो दिस सिस्टम वाइडली इन पर्शिया एंड मिडल ईस्ट. दे आर नॉट फॉलोड अप इन इंडिया, सम इन सम एरियाज ऑफ हिमाचल, बट नॉट एवरीवेयर. ओके, बिकॉज इट डिपेंड अपॉन द फ्लो ऑफ वाटर वी आर कैरियड, द फ्लो ऑफ रेनफॉल, द वेलोसिटी ऑफ रेनफॉल, वी आर कंसिडरिंग ऑल दैट. एंड फर्स्ट द सिस्टम रिक्वायर्स नो एनर्जी and relies on the force of gravity alone, and secondly the system can carry water across the long distance. Mean we are putting long tunnels, we are putting long pipes and put it into the base of the hill, so the water can move easily through that long tunnel and get I can say it get converge into main river or main pond, main hills. Okay, so and this consequently there is no leakage there, no evaporation there, no pollution there, and lastly the discharge is fixed by the nature. Means the amount of water get naturally into the river. Okay, without depletion, without any scarcity, I can say it can go easily into that river or pond or lake. So this is the system. Okay, there are long pipes we are placing longitudinally, and there is a mother tunnel there. Okay, this is the whole tunnel. Okay, it is gone in the irrigated land, or we can say in the river. What we have, what is the area, the structure of that area, it depend upon that. So we are placing tunnels. जिसको क्या बोला जाता है mother tunnel, then access shaft, then canal channel, then outlet, then distribution. So this is the diagram of canet system. आई होप दिस में हेल्प यू. थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स.